I am getting too old for this. Nope. Maybe? What's going on YouTube and welcome back to the channel. Today is our Card Vanguard Standard Market Watch, meaning in this video we're only going to go over cards in standard format to see which cards are money, which cards are minus, and which cards are plus. But before we begin, please remember to comment, like, and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Every Thursday Standard Market Watch, and every Friday, which is tomorrow, is our Card Vanguard Premium Market Watch. You know, just in case if you prefer to watch premium cards being bought off the market or not being bought off the market, maybe going down in the market, who knows. But if you guys want to watch any premium format cards in the secondary market, stay tuned for tomorrow. And of course, if you guys want to support our channel, we do have a link down below in our description box. If you click it, it'll take directly to tcgplay.com, and any purchase they make whatsoever off of our link from tcgplay.com, we get a small percentage and we greatly do appreciate it. Now today's market watch is going to be the Spice Melange, because there's more buyouts, mainly Grand Blue. The Grand Blue hype is already starting because Bushiroad just revealed the new Night Rose that we're getting, and a lot of people have been buying out so many Grand Blue cards. Like, almost all of my Grand Blue double R's and triple R's are gone. Like, it's insane. There are other buyouts, of course, and a few other cards which I don't agree with. Also, guys, keep in mind, I'm still getting these messages from people asking Rico what's going to happen to PayPal. A lot of people are still unaware of the new action that PayPal is taking. So, keep in mind, if you're going to buy cards off Facebook, off anything that's not an official website from an official company, and if you use PayPal, you will no longer have that PayPal protection. Because by the end of this month, PayPal will no longer protect any resale transactions. So basically, if you're buying cards off a regular person who's not from an actual store like Trollentoad, Ideal 8, PayPal is going to see that transaction as a resale transaction. And as soon as they notice that transaction is a resale transaction, PayPal will not protect the buyer or seller. PayPal will just close the case automatically. So again, guys, if you guys are going to buy cards from people on Facebook, Discord, anything like that, please be careful, because PayPal will no longer have that protection for you. Anyways, guys, let's go to the market watch to see which cards are money, which cards are minus, and which cards are plus. The first card that I want to talk about to start off this Grand Blue hype train, Greed Shade. This card, of course, when it first came out, it was going for like 10 to 15 bucks, and then it went down to $1 to $2. Now Green Shades are going for $10 to $11 with only 6 listings left. For the triple R's, market price is $10.33. As for the SPs, they're gone. They're not on the market anymore. In my opinion, Green Shades actually might be around $10, might go down to like $8. I don't see this card going anywhere near $5. Trust me. Yes, I know right now we're in the Grand Blue hype train. This card I can see holding its value between $8 to $10 range. Maybe it actually might go down to $5, but that's a huge maybe. Prism Necromancer. Even the VRs are $19 to $20. Wow. Okay, so the SVRs, there are 6 listings. Market price is $18.55. But in the 6 listings, there's one for $18. After that, $19, and then after that, $20. As for the VRs, there's 1 listing left near mint with 12 copies for $15 each, which I kind of highly recommend to pick up. After that, they're going for $20 each basically. Market price for the VRs is $8.90. Guys, if you have multiple copies of Ice Prison Necromancers, this is probably one of the best times to get rid of the VRs. As for the SVRs, I would probably raise them up to like $25, but if you're going to pick up Ice Prison Necromancers, I highly recommend to pick up the SVRs for $18, because honestly, in my opinion, Ice Prison Necromancer, I don't think it's going to hold its value. I'm pretty sure it's going to crash. The VRs are gonna go back down to like $10, maybe $11, $12, $13. It's not going to hold at the $15 to $20 range. After people realize that with the new Night Rose, we might not need the Necromancer April, Banshee. Now the SPs were bought off the market like weeks ago, but we want to talk about the Triple R's. Now the Triple R's, there's only two listens left. One for $10, after that $13. Market price is $871. This card is a phenomenal card. This card, in my opinion, I feel like it might become a $15 card, maybe even $20, God forbid $20 each. This card is a phenomenal card, especially with the new Night Rose skill. Maybe Ripple Banshee might go to $20, but I can definitely see that this card actually might become a $15 card. So if you guys want to pick them up, try to pick them up now for like $8, $9, $10, because like I said, guys, I honestly feel like this card can become a $15 card soon. Stormride Ghost Ship. This double R grade 2 used to be penny socks. It was not even a dollar. Now it's $3 to $4 because there's only 5 listings left. 2 of them for $3, after that $5, after that $6 and change. Market price is $217. You guys are monsters. Yes, I understand this card used to be terrible back then. Nobody wanted to play this card, but now with the new Night Rose skill, a lot of people are jumping on the Grand Blue hype train. And this is one of them. This card, in my opinion, I don't think it's gonna go past $5. Maybe it actually might become a $5 card. Stormride Ghost Ship, I can see it crashing maybe. Again, I'm not that too familiar with this card, so I can't really say anything bad or good about it. But again, Stormride Ghost Ship, in my opinion, it won't go past $5, but it might crash down to $1 or $2 again. Now, thanks to one of my viewers, he pointed this card out to me, Sunset Edge Dusk Blade. Now the SPs have always been around $9 to $10, hasn't really changed, but we want to talk about the Triple R's. The Triple R's are above the market price because there's only 6 listings left. A bunch of them for $8, after that $12. Market price is $2.73. This card used to be $2, but now it's about to become a $10 card. In my opinion, the Triple R's, they're gonna go back down. They're not gonna hold their value at the $7 to $10 range. The Triple R's will crash down to like maybe like $5, maybe even less. But if you're gonna pick up a Dusk Blade, God forbid this card actually does become, you know, a meta card that people want to pick up for the new Masai support, pick up the SPs. The SPs are going for $9, $10. They're a better investment, and they can definitely hold their value compared to the Triple R's. The Triple R's, in my opinion, I feel like they will crash back down to the $5 range. But if you guys actually have them and want to get rid of them, this is probably one of the best times to get rid of them for $7 to $8. Again, with help from one of my viewers, Brutal Jack. This grade 2 double R, when it first came out, it was a quarter. Then a week after it first came out, it became a $10 card. But a month after that, Brutal Jack became a quarter again. But now Brutal Jacks are up in the market. There's only 4 listings left. A bunch of them for $5 and change. After that, $7. Market price is $2.50. Brutal Jacks, in my opinion, it's a phenomenal grade 2 for Nova Grapplers. But we're not getting support from Novas anytime soon. In my opinion, Brutal Jacks, they will go down. They will not hold $5. They're going to go down to like $2, $3, maybe even a dollar. God forbid a dollar again. Brutal Jacks, they will go down. If you guys actually have them, get rid of them now. So I didn't point this out in the last Market Watch about this grade 2 rare for Gear Chronicles. It's getting reprinted, by the way. We're getting the Festival Collection next month, well, basically in a few weeks, and this card is one of those reprints. So instead of spending $8 to $9 for this rare grade 2 for Gear Chronicles, which you need, by the way, like this, every Gear Chronicle deck needs to play at least 4 copies of this grade 2. It's a phenomenal grade 2. It's getting reprinted, and I'm pretty sure the reprints are going to go for like a dollar, maybe $2, $3. Another card that's guaranteed getting reprinted in the Festival Collection, which comes out in a few weeks, Halo Shield Marks. Apparently, the double R's are still holding around the $12 to $14 range. Market price is $15.38. Don't even bother. It's not worth it. A Knight of Superior Skills Bowmanes are still holding at $12, $13. Hasn't really changed. And the PG for Ninectors are still holding at $8 to $9. Market price is $10.37, so it's slightly below the market price. But again, you can pick up the reprinted Common, the reprinted Triple R, and it's getting another reprint in a few weeks. So Maiden and Blossom Reigns. I highly recommend not to spend more than $5 on the double R's. Now, Metatron, a lot of people are picking them up, assuming that this card might actually be good again. Not too sure yet. To be honest, I'm not too familiar with Angel Feathers, so it's too early for me to say. But a lot of people have been telling me about this grade 2 for Angel Feathers. This Celestial grade 2, market price is $5.77. So right now at the moment, it's definitely above the market price from $7 to $8 with 10 listings left. This grade 2, in my opinion, it actually might hold its value between $8 to $10 range, because again, this card came from Ultra Miracle Collection. This extra booster was short printed. Well, technically almost every extra booster is short printed, but this extra booster was gone like the next day. Like this extra booster didn't have a chance to actually sell on Starks. But again, if you guys actually have this grade 2, don't get rid of them for $5. Get rid of them for $9 to $10, because again, Angel Feathers, we are confirmed getting more support later on, and this card actually might see some play, and people actually might want to pick up this grade 2. And again, it's been like what, a year and a half since this card came out, so it actually might be an $8 to $9 card. And the biggest buyout of the day, Dragon Undead Skull Dragon. Wow, $15. Keep in mind, at one point there were sellers trying to get rid of it for $30 and then $20. You guys are monsters, by the way. Anyways, there's 5 listings left, 3 of them for $15, after that $20, and then $30. Market price is $8.36. Now, yes, this card was slowly being bought off the market for a while now, but now it's $15. Insane. Last time we talked about this card, it was going for like $8 to $10. Now $15. I'm sorry that I keep repeating it, but it's just, I'm just amazed on how much the Grand Blue hype train has affected this card. Like, come on. Keep it like if you're as old as me, when this card first came out, penny stocks, barely a dollar. Then it became $2, and then eventually there was a hype train buyout for this card, and I don't know why it became a $10 to $8 card. It's been holding around that range for a while now, but now it definitely not. Now it's $15. Honestly, if I knew this was going to happen, I would have picked up like hundreds of copies of this card back then for quarters, because that's how cheap this card used to be back then. Now it's $15 each. Another card that one of my viewers told me about, he told me saying, Rico, this card actually might go up. I was like, I'm not too sure. So Captain Nightmiss, don't get me wrong, it's a phenomenal grade 2 for Grand Blue, and yes, this card used to be a quarter, used to be barely a dollar, used to be penny stocks, and it's been slowly going up in the market the same time as Skull Undead Dragon went up. So now there's 9 listings left, a bunch of them for $5, and then eventually $6, which I highly doubt is going to hit $6 each. But Captain Nightmiss, maybe they might go past the $5 range. I highly doubt it. But keep in mind, if you guys actually do have them, I would not get rid of them for less than $5, because again, maybe this card actually might go up. Now the last set I want to talk about, Psyqualia Strife. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys never heard of this set. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have heard of this set, but since this set was so bad, you forgot about it. And this set is so bad that it made one of the VRs, the most expensive VRs out of all of Carver Vanguard. Like, it's insane. This set was so bad, it made people not want to buy boxes, but spend over $20 for just one VR. And that VR is Escaplate Blaster. Now, the VRs are going for $27 to $28. Market price is $32 and change, with 15 listings left. Honestly, yes, this card is below the market price, but again, it's still very much expensive for a VR. As you guys noticed, a lot of VRs lately for Carver Vanguard and standard format, they're like around the $10 to $20 range, but this one's been keeping its value above the $20 range for months. It's been above the $20 range. As for the SVRs, there's 11 listings left, a bunch of them for $55, market price is $43 and change. Honestly, the SVRs, it actually might be worth $50. It's above the market price, yes, but again, who's actually gonna buy boxes just to get this SVR? They'd rather just spend that money to get it. They'd rather just spend $55 just to get the SVR. I'm assuming the boxes retail for like $20, $25 each. So again, the odds of pulling the SVR is not that good, especially if you're trying to pull just this one VR, because this box only came with one VR per box, and the boxes are going for $32 to $35. Again, there's barely any value in this set. The only value is just this VR. The heal triggers, the full art heal triggers, foils are going for $10 each. The SVR for Kagros, Novel Vagues are going for $10. The critical trigger full art foil for Ropaldins are going for $10. Flogos, $8. Tars are going for $5-6. And the heal trigger for Kagros going for $5-6. Again, like I said, this set is just so bad that it made one card in this set very expensive. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did indeed enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you guys are new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel for more videos. Every Thursday, standard market watch, and every Friday, which is tomorrow, is a Carver Vanguard premium market watch. Yes, I know today's market watch was very short. Unfortunately, there wasn't too many spicy cards, but I did find a few. Mainly Grand Blue. Like, the Grand Blue hype train is insane right now. Like, this grade 2, $35, and the worst one of all. The worst one of all, Skull Dragons, $15. What a good time to be a reseller. Anyways, I hope you guys are being well. I hope you guys are being safe. And I hope to see you guys always next time. Deuces.